have an order of boneless hot wings ready to burn.
Hey Jerry, how's it going, buddy? How's the audio? You got Nick DeFoya playing Jose Perica here, 4,000 at it, one pocket. Live from Bullshooters in Phoenix. This is the first match, so we got plenty of one pocket here for you. I think after this match, it'll be Scott Frost versus Angel Martinez. I'm not quite sure. I think around 30, roughly. I'm just going to, so let me go check and find out the number. So audio and video is coming in all right? You need to get down here and hang out. A bunch of people here. The place is packed. I'll be right back. Let me go find out. Head count was 29. Pretty good. It's a pretty good turnout for the first one, you know, and considering the Chuck Marculis tournament's going on. I think if they schedule it next year, not conflicting with that tournament, I think you'll easily see 35, 40, maybe even a full field of 48. I personally wouldn't even cap it, you know, because you got 3 days to finish it. You could have 64 show up, which I doubt you would probably get for a one pocket with a big entry, but, you know. Yeah, 58 killers. Yeah, I heard it's quite a field there for the Johnny Archer tournament that they're having. Looks like Nick has got two balls and Jose's got zero. Got a good field here, some real solid one pocket players. Got Jose Perica, of course, Scott Frost, Gus Priscina, Mike Pankoff, Bernie Petapiece, Preacher Rounds in the house. I see Pete Lotka. I mean, I see a lot of guys here. I don't know if I see Mitch Ellerman. I don't know if he's playing or not. I would be surprised to hear that, you know, he didn't play in this.
Kid from the West Coast, played real good, real strong. And yeah, he ain't been around for the last couple of years.
I'm not sure.
You got it, you know.
Not if I've seen him at all.
Junior national champion.
Real young.
Yeah, real young.
Austin Murphy.
Yeah, Austin.
He played Austin Murphy for the national a couple years ago. Nick, kid here. Yeah, man. It was awesome. He got lucky as hell. Kill Hill shit in nine ball, man. Kill Hill. Shit, man. Austin Murphy should have been the beat one.
Hey. Mm-hmm. What's up, man? How are you up to, Brett? I'll see you, buddy.
Thank you.
Hey, what's up, man? How's it going? Pretty good.
Has it already started?
Yeah.
Is this an actual match then?
This is the first one. Yeah.
It just started.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty good.
And you're streaming it for free, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, people like it.
Who can argue with that?
Yeah.
Well, they've changed the sound a little bit since I've been
Yeah, it's...
You got the Rose Shop, all the dark light, all the boards are over there now.
Yeah, it's a pretty good room.
Yeah. I remember when that first year or two that it opened, they had all the women pros like Robin Bell.
At the time, Robin Bell, Robin Bell.
And all those women players over here. Huh. It was a big deal.
Wow.
That was a long time ago. That was a long time ago.
Oh yeah, go ahead, man. All yours, buddy.
Heck, Jeanette Lee wasn't even playing pool, right?
Yeah, sorry for not letting everybody know out there that we'd be streaming tonight, but personally, I didn't think I was going to start streaming until tomorrow for the because we're only going to play probably two or three matches tonight, possibly. I mean, I know we'll play two for sure, but possibly three. But either way, we're here. We got some good one-pocket matches, and tomorrow we'll be starting at, I believe, 10 a.m. That would be 1 p.m. Eastern time for you guys on the East Coast. That will be the start of the first match for tomorrow. It looks like the ball count's still 2-0 in favor of Nick Tafoya over Jose Perica. How's everybody else's audio and video out there? Cool. Good to hear. Yeah, it's streaming and filming. It's streaming and filming, yeah. Yeah. I think he added 4,000, and yeah, I'd say it's probably 10,000 in the prize pool. Well, first place is probably 3,000 or 4,000 of it, you know. Yeah. Roughly. Yeah. Something like that. kind of like Jose trying to cross the 11 ball here and then run his cue ball into the stack. Might be a good shot, you know. Cross the 11 to his side and then just put his cue ball into the stack. Shot I like, but see what he does. I mean, he's a fantastic player. I mean, I think he's about 63 years old, and he's still competing at a very high level. That's a nice shot. Hit it pretty good. And you're probably going to see Nick move that ball. I don't think you're going to see him swing at the 13. It's real tight, you know. Thinking I'm probably mess with that. Hello, thanks for stopping by. See, Nick really wants to limit Jose's movement, you know, it's very important. This shot, you know, he's looking at it, but it's really a tough shot. Not a lot of reward in it either. Probably better off skimming the edge of the four ball and then going into the stack. Probably went off the two a little bit. It might have left Jose the three ball here because he can, you know, get the cue ball safe. You know, I think he can just bank the three. Free shot, essentially. So yeah, I appreciate you all tuning in. This is the 4,000 ad at One Pocket. We're live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. It's Jose Perica versus Nick DeFoya. First game, first match of this great tournament. After this, next up will be Scott Frost versus Angel Martinez. Angel Martinez is a good player from the Tucson area. For those who are not familiar with him, they will be firing at their hole for sure. This match, I think you're going to see a little bit more of moving and strategy, but if either one of these players gets a shot and gets let loose, they're going to run some balls. Hit it pretty good, but that's the problem, you know. He was hoping to bump the one ball there on his way up with the cue ball, and then he would have had cover behind the stack, but since he didn't, he went past the one and left Jose. Nice shot on the one ball. He's looking to come down here and get a nice angle to move that 11 ball, which is right in front of Nick's pocket. And that's, you know, that's key here, you know. You don't want to be stuck behind the stack, you know. Yeah, and now he's just going to move the 11 away. Might double kiss this ball away if he can't just stick it, you know? Good shot. Right now your ball count is 1-1. I'm not quite sure what to do. Let's see. How's everybody else's audio and video coming in? Cool. Nice simple shot there, you know, limit Nick's movement. Nick's just going to probably go off the ball down to the end rail. Just standard shot.
Mark.
Scott.
How you doing, buddy?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Ready to play?
How many viewers you got?
Maybe about 30 or 40, that's about it so far. But no one knew that I was going to be streaming today either. That was a good shot. Lucky shot. Open up the balls to his hole. Now the table strongly favors him. Now Nick's got to be careful, you know? I mean, because if Jose gets a shot, you know, he's going to... He could possibly win the game, you know, or get a good amount of balls. So the ball count right now is 2-1 in favor of Jose over Nick. Yeah, we'll be here all weekend streaming One Pocket from Bullshooters in Phoenix. If you're in the area, I suggest you get down here. Lots of good players and good times to be had. I think we'll be starting tomorrow at 10 a.m. or that's 1 p.m. Eastern for you guys on the East Coast. But after this match, we'll have Scott Frost versus Angel Martinez. You know, you might see the balls go start moving up table here, you know. I mean, it seems like they're both playing really tight. They had 29 players. It's a $200 entry, $225 for the latecomers, $4,000 at it. All the money from the entries goes right back to the players. It stays right in the prize pool. Nothing's taken out, no green fees, no sneaky BS, you know. Great tournament. I think they probably would have had a full field if the Chuck tournament wasn't going on there in California. I mean, there's a few tournaments going on. You know, you got Johnny Archer's tournament, you got the Chuck tournament. And I think next year there'll be a little bit more communication and less conflict. So that way, you know, players can enjoy both tournaments instead of having to pick one or the other. That's no fun. Good shot there by Nick. You know, like I said, you're going to see those balls moving up table. It's going to be a slow game. I mean, you know, unless somebody pulls something out of the hat. Oh, it's the first game still.
score is
2-1. I mean, the ball count is 2-1 in favor of Jose. Quite sure about the time limits. I'll find out and let you know. I think Trace is walking over now.
Hey Trace, what's the time limits on matches and the races?
3 hours.
Races are 3?
Yeah.
Each side?
Finals is going to be raced at 5.
Okay. And that's both sides, race yeah. 3, right?
Okay. Hey, we're going to start at 10 tomorrow.
Okay.
I don't know if you're going to be here.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I could come. It don't matter.
I'm going to try to look and see what might be your potential feature matches.
All right. Yeah, that works.
Yeah, it's a race to 3 and a 3-hour time limit on the match.
What's going on there, killer? Oh, crap. Tell him you're gonna open up a drink. Get a drink on. Nah. Oh man, you're no fun. 3. Yeah, on both sides. I'm against drinking too. On Sundays. Only on Sundays.
See, this is where they got to start creating shots and making stuff happen, you know. And, you know, he's probably looking at comboing into this 8-9 and putting his cue ball over there. Maybe off the 3, I'm not sure, you know. Yeah, he just went off the 3. Okay, not a bad shot. You know, because sometimes you try to get too aggressive and force something to happen, you know, bad things can happen to you. And he's banking the 2 or just crossing it over. Yeah, crossed it over. Shot. You're going to see a lot of this simple up table moving, just jockeying for position, hoping to get a good shot, you know, on a bank or something, you know. Wait for someone to make a mistake. I mean, it looks like, you know, the table would favor Jose since all the balls are on his side, but when they get wedged up on your side, it really doesn't help you that much. He played this?
My
child
favorite.
Yeah, right. Woo!
I don't know.
You know the important ones. That's what counts.
I didn't hit that hard enough, and Nick's going to be able to cross the three ball into the 15 and bring his cue ball probably down the table. I had a double kiss there, you know, and that's no good.
What's the story, Mr. Story?
Hey.
How are you, buddy?
Experiment.
Good to see you. How's your viewership?
It's just getting going. Probably about 40 plus people so far.
And a big stream up there in Sacramento at all?
Yeah, they just have like a, I don't know, maybe like a webcam or something set up.
That tournament, the one pocket tournament, already ran up there, right?
I don't know, maybe today's the last day for it.
That's what I'm thinking. It's got to be.
Thanks for coming out.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah, I appreciate you putting it on, you know.
I think it's not a bad turnout considering all the tournaments. You got Archer tournament, you got the Chuck tournament. I mean, if you do something like this again, you know, just keep the communication with Sacramento. Because I think you can fill this up without any problems, you know.
Pretty happy with 32.
That's what I said, too. 32 is pretty good.
If we had 16 tables, we could have no problem doing it.
Yeah.
Doing 48. But I started looking at the times on it.
You know what? 32 is pretty good.
Yeah. It is.
32 is pretty good.
Yeah. It is pretty good. You know, the thing is, with this tournament, and I think people will realize it, especially after this one, is that the money is better than the other one. Because they take out all types of shit, you know?
Yeah.
You know, they take out all types of stuff, and, you know. What's going on, Ronnie? Good luck in this, man. I hope you do
thanks.
Well.
Thanks. I got a good draw.
Yeah.
In your bracket.
Yeah.
You
taking a look at it.
Yeah.
Got some weak players, or,
well,
just, or people you feel your favorite over.
Yeah. That. Yeah. Well, that. I play the winner of this match here.
Okay.
But it's that Frost and Casino and stuff are in the bottom.
Yeah.
So if I can stay in the winner's bracket a couple of times.
Yeah. You'll do well.
You know.
I think you'll be all right, because, you know, I mean, you'll grind and stuff, and you know.
Yeah.
And you're comfortable here, you know.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Good.
Right.
You mean like, well, you got a top and bottom part of the bracket, and sometimes when they do a draw, you might have a bracket, like the top bracket might have some weak, a lot of weak players, or the bottom, either or. But then there's times when the one bracket has all the good players. So the person playing in that bracket is going to have a real tough time because there's so many good players in his bracket, you know? And that's what it comes down to. The draw is important for the players, you know? Because if they get a good draw, they're going to go far in the tournament, you know? But if they get, I mean, it'd be like, just say Scott and Jose had to play the first match. It would be tough because, and then just say after that there was another good player. Now they got to play good players one after another instead of playing maybe a few weak players and then they have to play, you know, so it makes a big difference. It's one of the most important things in the tournament is the draw. Who you have to play, you know?
Hey, what's up, hard hitter?
Yeah, right. That's funny. What are you doing, killer?
Nothing, just hanging out.
Nope.
Oh.
Ryan's playing, that's right?
Yeah.
Georgia.
Yeah.
Play,
yeah.
Play there right now.
He has a chance to win.
Georgia?
I mean,
being Georgia?
Yeah, because I only played Georgia in the tournament in game 7, and I won.
Yeah.
I mean, you can win.
They told me they don't want to stop playing, not feeling at all.
Yeah, so he said, why? So I said, hey, what's up? And he's like, I said, how you doing? And he's like, oh, I'm sick, and
yeah, he should have played. I don't know where he's at. Mr. Langston should have been here to play. Now we got a wedge game going. We got all these balls wedged up there, and this is going to be a long game, guys. I'm going to tell you that right now. The score is 2-1, favor Jose, and all the balls are wedged up on his side, and this game could, I mean, the game, we're already about 40 minutes into this game, I think, and I mean, it's this game, this first game here is probably going to go another 40 minutes, you know. But you can learn a lot, you know, from this part of the game, because a lot of times when you see two lower level players, they a lot of times get those balls out of play, you know, they don't really create anything, and you know, you gotta try to, you know. You gotta try to maneuver the balls here. First game, 40 minutes in already. This one's gonna, this game right here would be about hour and a half game, you know? You gotta have that stamina to, you know, I mean, you got some, when you get time invested like these players do right now in this game, neither one of them wants to lose it, you know, they're gonna really bear down even harder and grind it out, because, you know, who wants to lose a game that you've played for an hour, hour and a half, two, you know, nobody wants to lose those games, because it really demoralizes your opponent when you win a game that, you know, took a long time, you know. When you've made them suffer for an hour, hour and a half, and they lose that game, they're, you know, you're kind of crushing them a little bit. Oh, you can definitely learn a lot from this part of the game, because a lot of lower level players don't really know what to do here, you know? They're swinging at anything and everything a lot of times, and these guys are not really trying to do that. Good shot. Oh boy, he would have loved for that to fall, because he would have banked the 8 next, you know, and probably put his cue ball over into his balls a little bit and mixed them up. Nick's, he's got to be careful here, you know. I think he was trying to scratch there, maybe, to be honest with you. Because everything's down there, and there would have been two balls in the spot, you know? Instead, he's left Karika straight back. Wow, he got it right on the pole there. Not sure if Nick can move it. You know, it might be on the point. He might try to go rail first and then move it. Work out too good for him. Yeah. Yeah, there's a possibility. I mean, you're looking at him right now. You know, he's if you don't recall, I think a year ago at the Arizona State Championship, one pocket, Parika did win it. And Scott took third, and I think Bobby Emmons took second. So, you know, if anybody can do it, it would be this man here. But certainly Scott is a favorite. But wow, that was not a good shot. I mean, that's
hey, what's going on, man? How you doing, buddy?
Nah.
Just
gonna
broadcast?
Yeah.
Stick with this.
Got enough
to go
with.
Yeah, yeah.
You know. What about you?
I'm just hanging out
and
watching
the show.
Yeah,
just
hanging out.
Yeah, that's cool.
I've been playing like once every 2 weeks, and I'm having trouble playing.
Yeah.
Like this. Not that I really have a chance to play much,
but it's a good experience.
Yeah, it is.
Scott Frost and Angel Martinez will be up next on the stream table right after this match is over. So ball count right now is 3-3. This is the first game, race to three. We got Jose Parrico versus Nick Tafoya. 4,000 at it, one pocket live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. This is day number one, first match, game one. The streaming will start tomorrow at 10 a.m. for you guys here in Arizona watching. That's 1 p.m. Eastern for you guys on the East Coast. Hey, you're welcome. I appreciate it. You know, the contributions that... you know, people have made. I've been able to do a lot when it comes to the equipment. I got a HDMI capture device, a pretty sporty camera, and laptop. You know, a couple $1,000 worth of equipment. So, I think I'm going to change my chip in there on the website, and it's going to say Lenny's Beer Fund. This will be one of the last streams I'll be doing for months, though. I think this tournament here I'll be streaming this weekend, and after this tournament in about 2 weeks will be Preacher Ron's One Pocket. That will be my last tournament for about 6 or 7 months, because I'll be in Las Vegas for Bonus Ball doing video work there. So, if that would have went in, he would have been very unhappy. So, no on the rail for about 6 or 7 months while I'm doing the bonus ball. Yeah, if you guys are curious about what bonus ball is, you can go to playbonusball.com and check it out. They have a match video where you can kind of get an idea of what the game's about. It's got a little bit of everything in it. Snooker, one pocket, rotation, banking. It's just got everything. Wow. Jose's having a rough time here, you know? I mean, it's cue ball's getting away from him. Old spot shot, you know, that's a shot that you have to have for one pocket, for sure. I mean, many games are won or lost off of spot shots, especially at the lower level. I think it's one of the besides the break, it's one of the most important shots in one pocket is being able to make those spot shots when they come up, you know. Race to three. You're welcome. Counts 4-2 in favor of Nick. I'll be right back with you guys in a few minutes. All right, guys, I'm back. It looks like nothing's really changed, has it? Going for about 5 minutes there, I think, and everything looks the same to me. Ball count's 4-2 in favor of Nick over Jose Perica. I appreciate all you guys tuning in. Ooh, boy, he hit that ball good. Nick's going to be able to move that away, though, fairly easily. But be careful on these tables because they're 4.5-inch pockets, you know. Standard size, same size pocket as every diamond, you know, that you see for the most part. That's factory made.
What's going on, Ace? Playing the waiting game?
Wow, what a shot that was, huh?
Nice shot.
That was a real sporty shot.
Risky shot, right?
Yeah.
What's the score?
It's the first game.
If you don't know what the score is.
Ball count?
Ball count,
yeah. Yeah, it's 5-2. The balls are set up on the bottom there in the tray.
Okay.
Yeah, so if you're ever curious.
So, The kid is winning?
Yeah.
He's up 5-2.
No drinking on Sundays. No, first one. Taking a light tonight. Saturday, I'll do it up. Sunday, I don't drink. Pretty good. 29 players showed up. Not too bad. Considering the other tournaments that are going on. Nice. Yeah, Tim, you got to get down here and sweat it in person, man. We'll be here all weekend, so good crowd of people watching. Good turnout on the players.
What do you got, AT&T?
Yeah.
I'm not into that phone stuff, you know? I'm just not, are you? You're into it?
I don't know. Normally they do have these.
My girl got that Samsung Galaxy 3. I mean, it looks like a tablet. The screen isn't just big. You know, the phone is like that big. It's too big. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's way too big. I mean, I think it's good for a woman because they got a purse to put it in. But a guy putting it in their pocket, no good. You know what I mean? It's too big to put in your pocket like that and carry it around. But put it in your purse or something in a nice case, it's all right, you know? That's a nice phone. It's just too big for a guy to carry around. All right, I'll see you then. It'd be cool to see you. It's been a while. We've got to have a little rematch sometime, Tim. It's been a while. I've improved my game slightly, and yeah, I'm not playing in this. I'm just going to do the streaming. Just want to be focused on doing this instead of being away from the computer in case something goes down. You know, it's a pretty good event. And I want to give it good coverage, you know, if I have any computer problems. And also, BS with you guys, give some commentary.
I got all my contacts, nobody I need to call.
Yeah, I know. They bumped me to a 9. Can you believe that? I don't know how it happened. I guess it's all those stupid king of the 8 matches or whatever. But either way, it's okay. I know I don't play 9 speed. I'm probably like mid to high 8 speed. But I'm gonna just play into the rating like I did before. No big deal. I'll just play better. You know, I know I have it within me to play better, and I think all of us do if we really put in time and effort, you know, and focus on what we need to fix. That's funny, yeah, that's true. You got a point there. I missed the payphone, actually.
miss the payphones.
I miss payphones.
Whatever happened to the payphone?
It's dead.
I haven't seen a payphone in a long time.
Right?
When's the last time you've seen a payphone?
Well, your ball count's 5-2 in favor of Nick. Miscued, and he's got a spot of balls. 5-1 now. Man, these errors have costed Parika several balls. I think he's fouled 3 times in this game at least, and 2 cue balls in the pocket and that one little nippy foul there. And he's lost 3 balls. Otherwise, the ball count might, you know, very well be tied up.
I was watching some of that earlier.
Archer?
Yeah. I just hooked up my laptop to the TV in the bedroom, and I'm like, I was gonna like just sleep. I wasn't gonna come here. Because I mean, they're on playing with two matches. You know what I mean?
Yeah, still.
So what's the point of setting up for, you know? I'm, Pat Dicker. I come down Mark tomorrow. Minutes. You know.
Table 14. Pat Dicker. Mark
but I'm like, fuck it. I'll just do it and whatever. You know.
Next match on table 17.
It was pretty good to watch. I was watching Tommy Kennedy and Kim Davenport. I've never seen him play, Kim Davenport. You know, watched a little bit of it. I've been up since yesterday, so I'm fucking... I'm just like, I know I'm going to get goofy in a couple hours.
You're already goofy.
I know, motherfucker. Don't tell me twice.
You're losing it. How old are you? You look, you act like you're like 80 right now.
33.
Yeah, you're losing your mind already. Why are your eyelids so dilated? Yeah.
It's because we're in the dark.
Where is it? Look at this. Oh, what are you on right now?
I'm normal.
You can't be normal right now.
Yeah.
You're never normal. You are a strange bird.
Hey, dog.
Who wants to be normal anyway, right? I'd like to do that. I'd be kind of scary to be out on a boat. Jump in the water. That's because Jimmy, you know, crap. I'll never do that again. I'll never do that again with Jimmy. Shit, you know how many times I've done that stuff in my life? A lot. And I was always, I've maybe had 1 or 2 bad times, you know, out of all the time. I've had 1 or 2 bad times, you know, but that can happen going out drinking, you know. But Jimmy just, yeah, you can't be around somebody like him with doing something like that. Because he wants to mess with you too much.
Your ball count's 5-1. What was the challenge? Poker, pool, and fishing? Yeah, it was chilly this morning.
No, I'm off for 2 weeks.
It was cold. Yeah, I was. I was up this morning. I had all the windows open in our apartment, and it was like...
going to bed at 7, 8 o'clock in the morning.
What were you doing?
Yeah. Got wasted last night at Main Street.
Yeah. I was going to... I pulled up there, and I was going to go in, and I was like, man, I don't feel like hanging out here. I want to go home with this kill.
Oh, yeah. All kinds of drugs. I got 4 drunk.
But I don't need to get all wasted and not, you know, and drive home and stuff. I can't do that. It's not worth it. Not at all. I haven't really been drinking that much. You know, here and there.
That's 12 to 2, huh? That's not that much. He might give it to you. Yeah, right.
I got it right here. Start recording. 1 hour, 11 minutes. Isn't that crazy?
Burning questions from different people.
Yeah. That's to be expected. Fucking God. I mean, I couldn't stand. I can't stand to watch that. Just like a still figure. Are you gonna shoot? What's going on? Painful to watch that. I don't care how good you play. If I gotta watch you do that, I don't wanna watch it. I mean, you think he's frozen. Put him on the screen, it'll be like, stream froze. Like, listen.
No.
There's the guy who
just... He fell asleep.
Yeah. You feel like going, hey buddy, you alive?
Check his pulse.
Yeah, right?
What's going on?
Oh, I will.
I give you the first break playing one hole.
That's it.
Jose Parrica and Nick DeFoya. It's the first game. Race to 3 in the first match for the 4,000 out at One Pocket, live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. Thanks for stopping by, everybody, and hanging out. We'll be here all weekend. Tomorrow we start at 10 a.m. That's 1 p.m. Eastern Time.
I seen yours, and then I just had to get mine. What are you drinking? What do you have in your hand? Or are you somebody else's? Oh, man. I thought you were drinking. That's why I did it. That's bullshit. It's just not right.
What? This guy drink with it.
I know he will.
He's weird.
That's hard. He's weird.
You two together? Oh, my
yeah,
God.
Yeah, right.
Kill myself.
We're going out.
I can't handle you.
You know, when you're starving, bread is good. It is. True. That if you were starving, bread would taste good.
Gosh, shut up.
You and you guys are eating freaking bread with processed cheese. That doesn't look very good. Never. I've never ate that in my whole life. Oh, God. Probably yellow five in there or something, right? Yellow number $5. Only 20s. I didn't see him, which is kind of surprising. You would figure he would have been here. I want to go to a blues bar. You ever been to a blues bar? That's cool. Real, yeah, fun time, you know? You're just hanging out, listen to some good music, have some drinks. Nice atmosphere. Not like, not really into the club shit, you know? Grew out of that. Nah. Could kill you. Gonna kill you. That yellow five. Fuck, I don't know. Yeah. But I gotta be healthy to live. You know? Gotta be healthy to live. That's why I drink this. All you need here, barley, wheat, and hops. Did you eat today? Yeah. Yeah, we went over there and ate, I think, a while back, me and George and a few other people. It was pretty good.
This one right here?
Yeah, it was alright.
Go over by Fox Street. At the center, a little place called Mi Pueblo.
Yeah.
Fucking delicious.
Really?
It's between, there's a, like a Mongolian beef place, Peter Piper, or something else.
Huh. Yeah. Right. Well, you would know better than me. Sounds good, buddy.
I got that being modified today.
No brackets online, but I'm going to try to see if I can put something together. Just give me a little bit, and I'll try to work something out. Yeah, it's a black man. I think they used to have... it takes the HDMI signal from the camera into that box. Than a USB 3.0. I have no idea. I was always trying to figure out what that song, that G6 song, is.
about?
Airplane.
Airplane? I thought they were talking about a Pontiac. I was like, well, that's a $20,000 car. What are they talking about? Like, what are they talking about? This car. Yeah. Well, I don't know. That's the only thing I know from it. It's like a D6. And I'm like,
so high, like
a D6. Yeah. Whatever. A lot of it doesn't make any sense. It's a bunch of gibberish. Alright? I don't understand anything that they're talking about.
What are you
saying? No, I love everything. I do too, actually. All the types. I mean,
I love you.
I have a lot. Sometimes.
I love you all the time.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of what I was going to say. I was just laying in bed relaxing. Now I'm here. Hey, bonus ball. Bonus ball. Nah.
Why?
There might be something.
Are you
going
to play something tomorrow?
Huh? Nobody likes Cliff Jr. They don't.
I know, you're right.
They just don't like him. He's just not a likable person, I guess. I don't even know him personally. Yeah, it's about to be over, I think. It needs three balls. We make this in 98, right? We try to get on 13. Yeah, right. Huh? Alright. We got it. I got a...
Oh,
God. I think he rail the 13 and stop the star. You go right on the 6. Okay, nice shot. I'm excited about this bonus ball. It's gonna be fun. Just gotta find a house. Just, you know, to stay in there.
I'm saying, my friend, they're going to have an IBA in Oxford.
Yeah.
And last time I stayed there, the goal for it, what's his name?
Oscar.
Yeah. They had a
little.
Yeah.
I'd like to yeah. I mean, it might be better than staying with those guys, but, you know, the video crew I'm working with. I mean, it's going to cost me. I've hung out with those guys already. I've hung out with those guys already. Drinking in the hot tub, getting 30-inch pizzas delivered to the hot tub. I mean, we've hung out. Yeah, 30-inch pizzas. That's like a
side of this table. They deliver it right to the table. It's about the size of this table, deliver it right to you. In the hot tub. Drinking beers, they're like, hey, yeah, bring it. Let them in the gate.
Man, they're big time.
No, but fun. You know? 30-inch pizza. I mean, it'll be a good time. I enjoy myself. I mean, I don't really, to be honest, I don't really care for Vegas. I think it kind of sucks. I think Vegas kind of sucks. I don't really enjoy it. I've never done a tour of Vegas. I've always just gone there and gambled. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. It's not that great. All the times that I've been there, I mean, not really. And I've had fun later that year. That doesn't work well with the beer.
That's no good.
What is that? What is that?
I got a loose bone here. I got a loose ball joint. A loose ball joint in my arm.
Do you feel it?
This is like a little ball, right?
Ball joint.
That explains it all. Oh, boy.
Yeah, I don't care. We'll put it right there. That's better.
Right there.
Put it on top of that black bag.
That way, you know. That way you don't have to worry about it. Your ball count 6-5 in favor of Nick Toflo over Jose Parrica.
About 80 so far.
That's pretty good for, you know, that's pretty good for, and not only that, I didn't tell anybody, I didn't think I was going to stream today. I was going to wait and stream tomorrow because there's only two matches played tonight. I didn't really want to set up here. It's just, you know, a couple hours.
But you were showing up anyway, so.
Well, I was going to just relax and kick back today and then come up tomorrow in the morning. It's all good. Pretty good. I had a lot of fun. It was all right. Yeah. Got to see some old faces in different places that I hadn't seen in a while, you know? Yeah. Strutting that ass.
Look, that is!
Is this on?
Yeah.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Trace Keane 4000 Out of One Pocket Tournament here at Bullshooters. My name is Bob Stuckhart, and I will be your host for this evening. Any One Pocket questions, I'm glad to answer them.
Pretty good, right?
Yeah.
You don't need barrel.
What was that? What was he trying to do there?
I don't know, but I was right.
Yeah, that's fine, but jeez, I mean, how, I don't even do that kind of stuff. I would have just snipped the five out of there. Rail first, bam, put it over by the side pocket, left the cue ball there, money, winning, duh, Nick, no guarantees here, yeah, right. Might overspin it. Have a tough cut on the 7 ball. Can't wait to see you when you're 63 years old.
You too, bud.
Me too, I hope, right?
I can see what you're doing when you're 63.
Yeah, I'm going to look like Bucktooth. I'm going to like Bucktooth. What do you think you're going to look like? Big pimpin'? You're going to look like... You're either going to be fat or you're going to be skinny. Which one do you want to be?
I'd rather be fat.
Yeah, right?
For sure. I want to be something
that's funny. What kind of beer do you want?
I'm going to drink.
Well, then I'll have to get it to you sometime
soon. Your own tab.
Yeah. I'll drink one for you. And me. I can't believe you don't drink. My seats are worth more than your old fucking car. That was Scott Frost. He's just making funsies. My seats are worth more than your old fucking car. Oh shit, it was so funny, dude. I wish I had it on tape. That fucking guy. That is funny. I don't even know what he drives.
Dude,
right? Doesn't even drive.
I laughed so hard.
Well, game one goes to Jose.
She's an Asian leopard cat. Yeah. Not bad.
What's up, sir? Nice to see you, buddy.
What's up?
Oh, just hanging out. What are you up to?
How you been, sir?
Pretty good. Yeah. Not too bad at all.
How are you?
Good, you? Who's Greek playing here?
Nick Sequoia. pretty decent player. Is he from California? I think. I mean, he could be from New Mexico.
Is this tournament here?
Yep. First match. Yep. First match, and Jose won the first game.
What's the format? Race of three?
Race of three, yeah. Both sides.
Wow. Now they got it.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Good shot.
Rod came with you?
No, I came alone. Tomorrow's Eric's wedding.
Oh, yeah.
So everybody's scrambling.
Yeah. Again.
But this, yeah, he's been married before. But this girl's all right. Yeah.
I don't ever want to get married. Ever.
I tried it three times. Believe me, they're right. Third time's a charm.
Yeah.
I'm done with it, too.
Yeah.
But, of course, you know, I'm about to find a paper.
Yeah, I love it. I just don't need a piece of paper to tell me.
That's all it is?
Yeah.
It's a fucking piece of paper.
It's just another complication.
Who needs
really,
it?
Right?
Yeah.
Just another.
And if you're getting a piece, you gotta go to the asshole getting rid of the piece.
Yeah.
I agree.
No, thanks.
Thanks, guys.
It's just how it really is.
Listen, Heather. Thanks, guys, she says.
It'd be the smartest thing you ever do in your life, right? Never get married.
Yeah.
I believe it.
Tell you what, the last one cost me about $1 million.
Yeah.
I would have liked to have made that ball. Played a pretty good shot there. Jose's got three balls and Nick's got zero. But Jose is leading one game to zero over Nick Tafoya. This is a 4,000 at it live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. First match and first day of this 3-day event. We'll be streaming starting tomorrow at 10 a.m. That's 1 p.m. Eastern Time. The next match after this would be Scott Frost versus Angel Martinez. It'll be coming up right after this match is over. So I appreciate you guys tuning in, hanging out. If you're at OnTheRailTV.com, you want to support us, you can pick up a DVD or click on the chip-in. That's how we've made this all happen. I appreciate the support that we've gotten over the past 4 years that I've been streaming.
Players are good, Lenny.
29. Yeah, not too bad for $200 entry.
I kind of figured it would be at least 32.
Yeah. But I think
29. Though, yeah, that's.
They got that Chuck Margolis tournament going on this weekend in California. That's a big deal. Yeah, because that stuff in like the Swanee, those people go to that every year. They ain't gonna miss it for nothing.
Yeah.
So if you did it next weekend. Swanee. If we did it next weekend, we'd have 10-15 more guys from California to come play here.
I'm sure.
The money is you know? That's what hurt it, you know?
Yeah.
You've got to keep that in mind. He's got to keep that in mind next year, you know?
Absolutely.
If he does another one, I don't know.
Why would he, though? I mean, he's not plugging anything. He put his own money in.
So yeah.
He's
just
a pool fee.
Yeah. I mean, if he wants to do that, more power to him, right? Go for it. Yeah. I think he's retired now.
Yeah, he's a retired farmer. Yeah. So you know he's not a multi-millionaire.
No.
He's throwing away $4. He's real strong money.
Yeah,
in
sure.
In today's time, you know, it ain't much money, but it means something.
Oh,
you know,
for sure.
Rico looks like he's playing pretty good.
Yeah, not too bad.
He's like 63 now, I guess.
Yeah.
By the German
line, yeah. mean, he could try to bank the five.
Well,
but you know, it's not free, right?
It ain't free at all.
The nine? Yeah, play the nine off the 14, I don't know.
Can you get enough of the nine and stick the cue ball in the four? Because there ain't nothing here going to go. I don't think you can, though.
I think he's going to fire out his hole here.
He got a real one. It's hard to fade. Play good and get the rolls too, you're hard to beat.
Yeah.
How is this set up? What type of tournament is this?
It's a one pocket tournament.
Okay, so once you break in the pockets that it falls in, is your pocket?
No, you pick before the break. You pick a pocket, okay. And then you would break, and then the first guy to make eight balls in his pocket wins the game.
Okay, so both decide where their pocket's going to be, and
before
then,
the game. Yeah,
before
it's
the game.
It's one or the other, two corners right here.
Okay, I see.
Yeah,
then,
they get one or the other.
Once you decide on that pocket, and after the break, you have to get eight balls in that pocket?
Yep.
Oh, okay. What's the buy-in and what's the payout?
It's a $200 entry, and I think prize pool's probably about 10 grand, so first place probably about 3 or 4,000. Pretty good.
How far are they in the ladder right now? Like, how,
this is the first match.
Oh, this is the first?
Yeah, this will be going on all weekend.
All weekend?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And just after they finish, then the next time, the next
time. Oh, yeah.
Keep, how many people are in?
29 players.
29 players. Oh, okay.
Yeah, people from all over the place.
Awesome. I appreciate it. Thank
yeah,
you
no
much.
Problem, buddy.
Looks like he's going to go into the five. No, he tried to come around, but I don't think that's good enough. I think Nick might have the 4-5 combination here, possibly. Not quite sure. He's looking at it now. If he doesn't, he's going to try to have to, he'll probably have to do something with the 13. Maybe shoot almost straight into it and double kiss it, you know, and move it over just slightly over to the side and block him getting a hit on the five. Looks like he's really going to wind up here. Yeah. Just joking around. Yeah, if you guys know who Jay Helford is, he's there in the top right-hand corner of your screen, sitting down, talking to the guy in the red tank top. That's Jay Helford. Players.
Hey, how are you doing, buddy?
Thanks for doing what you do.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you. Glad you're here playing in it.
I've been sick for 9 days. I wasn't sure I was coming.
Yeah, right. What do you have?
I got this shitty cold.
I'll feel better. Seems like you're not too bad now.
No, I feel okay. When I lay down, I cough. That's my problem.
Yeah.
I can't believe that kid lost that game.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it either.
Well, he just made a couple of key mistakes.
Yeah.
That's all it takes against Oakland.
For sure.
Yeah.
Never stop.
You're welcome. You should be here, man, hanging out.
At least I got a draw. I could definitely play a world beater out of the box.
Yeah, right. Who do you play next?
I play Pete. I play Pete Marta, and tomorrow I play Jay Helfert.
Oh, yeah.
And Jay's a good player.
Yeah.
You know, he's just a little old like me. So
I like you in that game, two. I guess. Yeah.
Well, if I make balls.
Yeah,
that's the key. I'm gonna leave by the end rail. I want to see how he shoots from the end rail.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Find out.
Yeah,
and, I mean, that's one of keys, Scott's keys, and
I'll mess with Jay tomorrow when I see him. What time do you guys play tomorrow?
10.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna tell him and say, hey, bet 50 on the side. I'll let it. But we're getting riled up.
Oh, I'm not saying he plays bad.
No, but I like you in that game for sure. I seen him play about a year ago when I was at that California Billiard Club. He played a guy. Gambling with them and didn't beat them. I think they broke even. And I played the same guy, same night, and I beat the guy. It was kind of like, you know, I wasn't too impressed. I don't know. He could have been laying down, waiting for something, you know, better.
He's just older.
I don't know.
Are you talking on him?
Here and there.
I don't know this guy's name. Who's the kid?
This guy right here, Nick Foyle?
Nick.
Yeah.
I think mixed up with Tom, though.
I don't know. I think he might be from California.
I think it's Alpha. Yeah. Well, I'm going to put my cue away before it disappears.
Yeah, especially in here.
You think?
How was your trip back east?
It's pretty good. I had a good time, man. Good month away and just... Got to see a lot of people. I drove about 6,500 miles.
You making any money doing this stuff?
Not really, no. It's more of just a hobby.
Yeah, but how are you doing it? How are you making a living
now? Basically all types of online sales, so that's all I do pretty much. Like electronics. I mean, I do sell some cool things, but, you know, not stuff to do with this really. I'll be working, making money doing bonus ball in about a couple weeks.
Are you going to be attached to that?
Yeah, I'm going to be doing video work up there for about 6 or 7 months. So.
6 or 7 months?
Yeah.
Do you need help?
We got a 5-man crew for the video. 5-man crew. I'll be in Vegas for 6 or 7 months living there.
Wow.
Doing the video. It's a $3 million deal that they got.
Ooh, you're making some money. Good.
That'd be good. Yeah.
That's good. I meant what I said.
Yeah, thanks. Man.
Over $3 million, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, over $3 million.
Is anyone going to be streaming it?
They're going to be doing, I think, pay-per-view format there.
That's what I meant.
Yeah, it's going to be pay-per-view streaming probably. It's going to be good stuff, although it's going to be real high quality and all the top players. So.
Cool.
Yeah, it'll be pretty good.
Yeah, Scott said they spent a lot of money on cameras.
Yeah, $150,000 equipment. Yeah, it's pretty good. We'll have good stuff to work with. We had good stuff last time when I was up there a couple months ago, but this is even better. It's all new.
Right.
Oh, yeah. I hope it works out for them. I mean, they're putting a lot of money behind it.
Yeah, no kidding. Jeez. I missed a call.
Ball counts 3-0. Well, 3-1 actually. Nick's at the table. Jose's leading in this game, and he's also up 1-0 in the match, race to 3. He missed that bowl, and he's left Parika the 11. I don't think you're going to see Parika shoot up this. I'm not sure if he can really get on anything else, maybe with a little bit of a low right-hand spin. Maybe he can come between the 8 and the 14. No room here. That was probably that table. Yeah, I'm looking at Nick right now. He doesn't look too confident in his chair. I mean, he's made a few errors. I think he should have won the first game. I mean, all of us who were watching fully expected him to. And sometimes you can just make an error. I mean, see like this, you know, Parika kind of trapped himself here. And, you know, this could let Nick back in the game, you know. He doesn't play really smart here because, I mean, this is not good. It's just trouble, actually. Parika might be leading 4-1, but he's in a little bit of a pickle here, and he's got to play a smart shot to not let Nick back in the game. Because if Nick gets a shot, the way the balls are laying, it looks like he can get a few balls. Foul there, but Nick wants to keep control here. He's gonna probably have to. I think he's trying to look at rolling him down on the 12, but I don't know if he can get past. But he needs to protect those balls that are in front of his pocket and put pressure on Parika. I mean, that's important. Two now. He didn't get a rail, and Parika's gonna have to try to move the three ball here. See him shoot to six ball here. I mean, this just would be a terrible shot. He's got to do something with a three without giving up a shot to Nick. It's going to be, it's not easy to do that necessarily, you know. Rika's not happy here, you know. He's really looking hard at what he wants to do.
thank you, sir. A good shot that he hit there. I think you're going to see him play the four and maybe draw back for the two if he's got the right angle. I don't know if he can come down for a bank on the three or not. Might not have enough room there with that 14. Yeah, Parika's leading 5-2 right now. He needs 3 balls and he'll be up 2-0 in this race to 3 over Nick Tavoya. Looks like he might play the 9 ball and then get on the 2.
Thank you.
Jose, he's up 2-0.
Well, these two are mine after my match.
Alright.
Where do I hide this at?
I would put it on the floor.
I don't know where to put it.
I don't know.
Anybody touches that, I would fucking
go. Looks good, though. I mean, yeah, it is good.
Jose Perica's leading 2-0. This race to 3 over Nick DeFoya. Jose.
Leave it in?
Yep. Thank you. Your ball count's 4-3. Ball count's 4-3 over Perica over Nick Tafoya. Jose's leading 2-0 in this race to 3. Ball count now is 5-3 in favor of Jose Perica. You're watching the 4,000 Ad at One Pocket live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. Perica is up 2-0 on this race to 3 over Nick Tafoya. Your next match after this will be Scott Frost versus Angel Martinez. Should be a match with a lot of firepower, and those guys will be shooting at their holes, so that'll be coming up next. Thank you. I like it sometimes on my pizza.
No. No.
Too bad Jeff Woods ain't here. He might have taken that. $50.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. What are you, get lost in the woods in Flagstaff or something?
Well, Jose takes it down, and Scott Frost is coming up next. Scott Frost versus Angel Martinez, your next match. Good match by Jose Perica to grind it out.